It is official. After spending the first week online only, students in Hillsborough County can physically go back to school if that's what their parents originally planned. This is after a long back and forth battle with the state that involved threats to pull funding, lawsuits, and very passionate discussion. 10 Tampa Bay's Candace Aviles shows you how we got here.
Let's wait and see how many more get sick is not a plan. I want to read you a list of teachers that I know that have died in Florida from COVID.
While teachers shared their safety concerns mid-pandemic, parents demanded change.
I honestly can't take more of this back and forth nonsense. It's driving me and my children nuts. It's also costing me a small fortune to find childcare out there every time you make a decision.
They long desperately to be back in school, okay? They want to see their caring teachers' faces and be with their friends. Instead, they are in an electronic prison.
Besides parents' pleas, the school district faced the threat of losing more than $200 million in funding from the state if they didn't allow kids back in the classroom. On top of that, the lawsuit involving the state's largest teachers union prompted Superintendent Davis's recommendation.
My recommendation as superintendent for the board to rescind their vote as of August 6 for the 4 weeks of e-learning.
The board supporting that decision in a 5-2 vote, then focused on other safety problems.
At what positivity rate percent of teachers out do you decide to shut down a school?
Davis didn't have a specific answer, but says a tracker they have will help with making that decision. Another discussion point, what about teachers worried for their health and safety?
I understand that there's fear. I hear it through voice in many conversations, through emails that I receive or conversations that I receive, whether it's in the building or in the community. And we, you know, I am to a place where we have taken and educate them on how many steps that we have taken in order to provide the necessary PPE to be successful.